I grew up in the mountains of Colorado, and I remember all of these winters that we spent, you know, chopping wood in the snow and surviving in the wintertime. And I fell in love with the snow, and I wanted to bring that into my professional life.
I'm a climatologist, and I've turned into a glaciologist, a person that studies snow and ice, because my entry into this world was through skiing. And so now it's all about understanding climate, and because it's boiled down to relatively simple physics here. It's the amount of snowfall on one side of the equation, and on the other side, it's how much melt there is.
The Greenland ice sheet is a leftover from the last ice age. And so it's like a sleeping giant that this warming is waking it up again. You know, we go to Greenland because it's like a ground zero for climate change. And there, all we have to do is get some numbers in the field, some hard numbers, to check the models and the satellite measurements, where we're bringing kind of low tech to check the high tech information.
Every time I move the helicopter, we release a lot of amount of snow.
Greenland is key in understanding climate change because right now it's delivering the most to sea level rise than any glaciated place in the world, including Antarctica.
Global warming has put more moisture into the atmosphere, and we can see that with more snowfall on Greenland. So that's competing against the increasing in melt. The Greenland ice sheet is losing so much ice these days, it's about 8,000 cubic meters per second, round the clock.
You can see what's under the snow here is a climate station, and it's recording how much melt there is. It measures sunlight intensity with this sensor here, wind speed, air temperature, humidity, etc.
The way we measure snowfall on Greenland is very simple. You really just measure the thickness, and we weigh how much snow there is. What we do is we drill down just to the last summer, and we take that snow out and we simply weigh it. How much water came out of the sky? And this low-tech measurement we use to check the high-tech satellites and climate models. One strong impression you get working in this environment is just how quiet it can be and just how alone it can feel. You know, we live in a busy world, lots of people and noise, and so you can, it's like a getaway.
Okay, guys, I just got off the phone with the Met Office, and the weather outlook is really terrible. We can already see these high clouds coming in. Midday, we should have light precipitation.
Warmer temperatures also threatened the safety of this traverse, and we had to rush off of the ice sheet because there was actually a lot of rainfall coming, and that would have like cut through the snow and made it really unsafe to ski across. So even though we planned for 9 days of camping, we ended up only having four. The reason we have to go to Greenland is there's no other way to get these measurements than to go there on the ground and drill the snow. In this way, we can evaluate which is winning this competition between increased melting or increased snowfall. What we find is that melt is winning this competition, and the implications are more sea level rise, more changes to ocean circulation, and disruption of the climate system.